Thank you. Mr. Saxophonist. So beautiful. Good morning, everybody. Yeah, we just want to thank you. I want to thank Odile, who has put a trust in me to do this funeral this morning, and also to Claudette. I want to share my condolences with the family and friends this morning, relatives. We pray that God will strengthen you at this time. We pray that His hand will be upon you. We pray that you will be with you during this time. We have lost so many families, so many friends, so many people during COVID. And, it was just another level. We had to just lose people. But today, I want to assure you, give the assurance. I can be long, but I'm going to try and be short this morning. Okay. Maybe if we can just sing the first song before I pray. When peace like a river attendeth my soul, my away, when sorrow like sea billows roll. You go. When peace like a river attendeth my way, when sorrows like sea billows roll, Thou hast taught me to say, it is well, it is well with my soul. It is well with my soul. It is well, it is well with my soul. Though Satan should buffet, though tired should come, let his best assurance control. Christ has regarded my helpless estate, and that shed his own blood for my soul. It is well with my soul. It is well, it is well with my soul. My son, oh, the bliss of this glorious thought, my son, not depart, but the whole is nailed to the cross, and I bear it no more. Praise the Lord, praise. swell it out now. It is well with my soul, with my soul. It is well, it is well, it is well with my soul. Can we pray? Heavenly Father, we thank you this morning for this wonderful occasion, this beautiful day that you blessed us with. We thank you that you give us life, and you give us life in abundance. We thank you, Lord. It's only by your grace this morning that we can be standing here at this open grave. And Lord, just to come and pay our last respects. And Lord, to lay to the ground the body, the remains of Jacqueline. We pray this morning, Lord, through all of what we are doing this morning, that you'll be glorified through this. We pray for the family. We pray for relatives tonight, this morning. We pray, Father, that you will be with them right now, that you will comfort them as you can comfort them. Your word declares, I will send the comforter, and he will comfort you, and he will guide you, and he will teach you. And he will be with you. Your word declares also, Lord, it says, that I will not leave you, neither will I forsake you. I will be with you unto the end. We thank you, Lord, that you are here, because your word declares that where we are gathered in your name, you are in the midst. And so, Lord, be glorified in all of this, in the mighty name of Jesus. And all the people of God says, amen, amen, amen. Hallelujah. As I said earlier, I'm so thankful to Odile and Claudette. It's an honor for me to lay to rest the body of Jacqueline. As I said, I'm not going to be long, so I'm going to hand over to Howard, who's going to do us a song. And please just enjoy as you listen to the song. Thank you.
Back again to hold you in my arms and hear you when you cry. It's not easy to say goodbye. I remember all those good times we had. So many memories, some good, some bad. Yes, and through it all, those memories would last forever. There's peace in where you are. Maybe that's all I need to know. And if I listen to my heart, I hear your whisper once more. And so I have to say, I'm just glad you came my way. It's not easy to say goodbye. It's not easy to say goodbye.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Howard. Oh. Yeah, as you all know, it's not easy to say goodbye. Can you hear me over there? Can you hear me over there? Sometimes I don't have to use the mic. So I can throw my voice right to the back over there. I'm very short, very small, but I have a very loud voice. So, yeah. Praise the name of Jesus. We thank God for that song. It's not easy to say goodbye. It's a secular song, but it means so much. And many of us as families, it's very, very difficult when one passes on in our family to say goodbye. It's tough. I can remember 2019, my wife and I and Howard only had two sons. And 2019, we had to say goodbye to our younger son. But there were three deaths in a row. It was my sister in January, 2-3 weeks later, my sister-in-law, and another month later, my son. Three deaths in one row, just like that. So you can imagine, it's very difficult. And then later through the year, some more deaths. That's what, it wasn't even COVID. And in COVID, so many lives have been lost. And I'm standing here this morning, also being at the memorial last night to do a funeral tomorrow again. And just as we were on our way here, we just heard some more bad news. The grandson of the gentleman who passed on Sunday, where we had the memorial last night, his grandson last night was murdered. Oh, I'm telling you. But the Bible says, absent from the body, but present with the Lord. Death is part of life. Did you know that? Death is part of life. We all have to go that way. Amen. And I'm going to be very simple this morning. And I'm going to share with you just one simple scripture. And that is found, and it's, we all know the scripture. John chapter 3, verse 16. Simple. For God so loved the world that he gave, emphasis on gave, that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. The body perishes, but the soul lives on. Are you together with me? You can talk to me when I talk. I like people to talk with me when I talk. Because you don't talk to me and I think, oh, I get worried. Are the people okay with me? Yes. This is actually a celebration. It's a celebration of Jacqueline laying her body to rest. Her soul, the Bible, as the Bible says, absent from the body, present with the Lord. She's present with the Lord. So, my emphasis is laid on, for God so loved the world that He gave. God is in the giving business. When God created the heavens and the earth, as we read in Genesis chapter 1, and He created you and me in His image, He gave you and me life. Wow! Thank you, sister, for agreeing with me. Life in abundance. We have abundant life. Some of us, we live life so morbidly. We live life so sad. We live life, and all the pressures of life wants to get us down. But I want to tell you something, that God has given you life. By breathing His God breath into your very being, into your nostrils, and it was God's life in your lungs, and His life giving blood flowing through our veins and through our arteries. Without God, we don't exist. Without God, that means, look at this beautiful day today. Look at this beautiful day. This is life. When I awake in the morning, I was ministering last Sunday and I was saying, I want to worship when I wake up. When I wake up, I want to worship. Before I go to the phone, I want to go to the throne. Oh, do you catch it?
Oh, you catch that.
Oh, so many of us, we go to the phone first before we go to the throne. Yeah, but here's my thing. You see, when I wake up, I go to my phone and I get to my Bible app.
You see?
So I open up my Bible app and I want to hear what's God saying to me today. Not how much money am I going to make today? Ooh, the guys are going to give me trouble today. Oh, my jobs. No, I want to hear what is God saying to me. So before I go to the phone, I want to go to the throne. I want to talk with God because I want to worship Him. Because the very air that I breathe is God-given breath. Amen. So without God, we do not exist. That's according to Genesis chapter 2, verse 7. It says, the Bible says, that when He formed man from the dust. So we're all dust. Do you know that we're all dust? We're all dust. So the interpretation of dust is dirt. Hey, dirt. But I want you to say this morning to yourself. I am good dirt. I'm good dirt. Amen. So we're from the dust. And there were instructions given to Adam. Did you know that we were not supposed to die? We were not supposed to die. We were supposed to be living forever. In the garden, God gave Adam and Eve an instruction. Do not eat from the tree of life, of knowledge and life and knowledge. Do not eat of the tree. He says, that stands in the middle of the garden. If you do, you will surely die. Now that die meant that Adam would die to the knowledge of God. Ooh. Because you see, in the garden, God had an affair with Adam. They had a personal relationship because God would visit him in the evening and they would talk. So he had a great knowledge of God. So because of his disobedience, he was separated from God. Separated from the knowledge of God. Are you with me? Amen? Because sometimes we do things in our own way. We do things that seems right unto God, but it's not God's way. Are you with me? So that's not the knowledge of God. So, because of Adam's disobedience, we die. But listen, Adam is the first Adam. And God said he had to send his son. Jesus, his son. Jesus was already in the beginning. The Bible says in John chapter 1, and in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was God, and the Word was with God, and the Word came and dwelt amongst men. So Jesus was in the beginning, but because of Adam's failure, the Bible says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. God didn't send his Son into the world to condemn the world, as we condemn one another, as we judge one another. You just, you see somebody doing wrong, we judge. We are living in judgment all the time. But God did not send his Son into the world to condemn us, but to give us life. To those, he gives you life, to those who believe in his name. I might be trembling on some toes today here. But some people don't even get near the church, but they believe in God. And they believe in Jesus. They believe that they exist. They believe in the Lord. The Bible says that even to those who believe in his name shall be saved. Believe in his name. We need to fellowship. We need to fellowship. We need to be amongst the brethren. We need to be amongst the sisters. Because how will we encourage one another? We need to be amongst one another. But the Bible says that, yes, that we have been given life if we believe in him. Jesus Christ came to die upon the cross so that you and I can have life. And I believe, Jacqueline, from a born date to her died date, there's a hyphen in between. And in between, which is called that hyphen, God knows about that gap. God knows everything about you and me. God knows about Jacqueline. Her highs, her lows, her ups, her downs, the bad, the good, the sad, the happy moments. God knows everything about you, and yet he does not condemn you. Oh, Lord. He doesn't condemn you. We condemn one another. The Bible says in John 14 and verse 6, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father but through me. There's no other way to the Father. You have to come through Jesus. I'm not coming through the Father or through the priest or through the pastor. I have to come through Jesus. Amen. So I believe that Jacqueline had a chance to call on the Father through Jesus Christ. Her last breath that she has released before she passed on is the same breath that she has been given when she was born. So we stand before this open grave, which is where we all have to end up one day. So from the dust of the earth, she was formed in the womb of a mother. Did you catch that? So from the dust of the earth, we all dust, you remember that? We all dust. She was formed in the womb of a mother. Her soul has returned to the Father. And her body now has to return back into the womb of the earth. There's a hole here. It's open. It's the womb of the earth. And our bodies go back to the earth. Amen. Like Jesus was placed in the tomb, she is placed in this tomb. Amen. The open grave, my friend, this evening, this morning, is not the end. It's just to lay to rest the body. Amen. She has passed on through from this life to her new life. Amen. So, let us proceed. Father, this morning, we thank you, Lord, for this time to share and to hear your word. We pray, Lord, that you will help us to receive from you. We pray, Lord, that we will not take your word lightly. We thank you for life. We thank you for giving us life. We thank you, Lord, that you have given us abundant life. So we pray, God, that you will bless your people as we stand around this open grave. And this will be a reminder that I need to be in close communion with God and have a good relationship with God and with my neighbor. I pray that you will be with your people. I thank you for forgiveness. I thank you for your blood that was shed. I thank you, Lord, that we are forgiven and we forgive others. We pray in Jesus' name, be glorified in all of this. Amen. All men are like grass, and all their glory is like the flowers of the field. The grass withers and the flowers fall, because breath of the Lord blows on them. Surely the people are grass, the grass withers and the flowers fall. But the word of God stands forever. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me will live. And even though he dies, and whoever lives and believes in me will never die. Do not be afraid. I am the first and the last. I am the living one. I was dead, and behold, I am alive forever and ever, and hold the keys of death and Hades. Death has been swallowed up in victory. Where, death, is your victory? Where, death, is your sting? But thanks be to God, He gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. We brought nothing into this world, and we will take nothing out of it. Blessed are the dead who die in the Lord. From now on, yes, says the Spirit, they will rest from their labor, for their deeds will follow them. For as much as it pleased Almighty God of his great mercy to receive unto himself the soul of our dear sister, Jacqueline, here departed, we therefore commit her body, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust. We do this in the sure and certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, who shall change our earthly body that it might be like his glorious body, according to the mighty working whereby he is able to subdue all things to himself. Amen. Thank you. Let us pray. Father, as we commit the remains of Jacqueline to the earth, we pray, God, that this open sepulcher, this open tomb, will remind us of our relationship with God, that we allow him to have his way in our lives, that one day we will come this way. We pray in Jesus' name that as we close this part in Jacqueline's life, that as family and relatives, my God will continuously look to Jesus, who's the author and the finisher of their faith. You pray this in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. God bless you. The blessing of God maketh rich, and he adds no sorrow. May he be your portion today. Amen. Can we do that song, Amazing Grace? I like that song that you just played. Yeah. Yeah, the saxophonist will do that for us, and we just follow him. Amen. Can we give him some sound there? Thank you. That's it, a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious deed that grace appear, the hour I first believe. Through many dangers, thwarts and snares, I have already come. The Lord had brought me safe thus far, and grace will lead me home. The Lord has promised good to me. His word, my hope, secures. He will my shield and portion be, as long as life endures. Amen. God bless you. Thank you.
it hasn't been for the Lord that was always on my side. The enemy would have swallowed me, would have drowned in the waters. But my soul has found an escape, a hiding place in you. The foulest snare is broken, and my help is in the name of the Lord. I'm nothing without you, nothing without you. You are the air that I breathe. I can't live without you. I can't move without you. In you I live and move and have my being. I'm nothing without you. Nothing without you, Jesus. You are the air that I breathe. I can't live without you. I can't move without you. In you I live and move and have my being. Hosanna to Jehovah. You are the air that I breathe. Hallelujah, hallelujah. In you I live and move and have my being. I'm nothing without you, nothing without you. You are the air that I breathe. Can't live without you. Can't move without you. In you I live and move and have my being. Nothing without you. Nothing without you. You are the air that I breathe. Can't live without you. Can't move without you. In you I live and move and have my being. Yahweh, Yahweh, lover of my soul. Yahweh, 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 lover of my soul. We bow down and worship Yahweh. We bow down and worship you. We bow down and worship Yahweh. We bow down and worship you. Yahweh, 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 lover of my soul. Yahweh, 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 lover of my soul. We bow down and worship Yahweh. We bow down and worship you.
We're going to call on Chanel, Roxanne, Maggot to come and do the eulogy. And then we'll call on Michael George to do the vote of thanks. Okay. Chanel.
Oh gosh. Good morning, friends and family. Let me start off by saying I wrote this eulogy trying my best to sum up the woman we all came to know and love, Jacqueline Gladys Maggot, in a few pages as possible. This was a challenge for me. For those of you who don't know me, I am Jackie's daughter, Roxy, the youngest of her three children, whom she leaves behind, along with her adored fur baby, Patches. When I think of my mother, I think of a woman that was rich. Rich in character, rich in generosity, and rich in faith. My mom was not one for worldly possessions and often gave away whatever she could to whoever needed it. She was a strong woman and determined to make a difference in this world. She was not only someone you could spend hours talking to, but someone you can depend on no matter the circumstances. Please turn the page. Thank you. My mom made friends wherever she went, from all walks of life, and was undeterred by where you came from or what you looked like, and treated everyone with the utmost respect and unwavering kindness. Jackie, or Jax as she was fondly known, was fondly known, and she loved to laugh. You would know my mom was in the vicinity just by her infectious laugh that could turn even the most serious of conversations into a joke. When she laughed, we laughed. My mother was also a firecracker, for those of you who don't know. When she was upset, you would know it. And even though these were very short-lived and rare occasions, she'd always say to me, "There are three things I cannot stand. Don't lie, don't mess with my kids, and don't mess with my family." My mom was a God-fearing woman. Irrespective of the adversities we or anyone else face, she found her comfort in the Lord and often quoted Bible verses no matter what the conversation or situation was. I'm shaking. Jackie had many quirks. She enjoyed horoscopes, reading up on the interpretation of dreams, and provided and could provide home remedies for anything to cure whatever disease or ailment you had from A to Z. She hated eating out, and once upon a time, believe it or not, was allergic to cats. And every so often, you would find her knitting while watching anything from the Wildlife Channel to some Turkish Afrikaans Telemundo show. She was also quite business savvy and embraced any venture thrown away. She never shied away from a challenge. She was the very essence of a people's person and loved the terms of endearment, such as my baby, my angel, my scat, hello, my sweetheart, darling, honey, and pretty much anything else you can think of. There is so much more I could say about my mom. However, I will end off by saying that she cared deeply and loved without prejudice. Mommy, we will miss you. Fly high, angel pie. I love you till we meet again.
Michael George.
Morning, everyone. Just a vote of thanks to a couple of people, but first and foremost, we give thanks to the Lord for giving us Jackie. Not only giving us Jackie, but giving that laugh. Because when you're in your quiet space, that laugh will make you smile. And be able to share her with us. Secondly, we'd like to thank Dove Funeral Services, Plumstead, especially Mary Ann, for assistance during this time. Duncan Johnson for providing the beautiful saxophone music. We truly enjoyed your presence. And to the extended family, a special note to Roger Jensen for assisting with all the little things. To Auntie Anne and Uncle David for their contributions on behalf of the family in Johannesburg that unfortunately were unable to attend in person. To ADY team live event streaming, thank you for making this possible for so many friends and family that could not attend. Thank you to Pastor Trevor Busby. We truly appreciate your sermon and your word of encouragement. Thank you to DG Outsource for sending the family a few goodies, flowers, and also showing their love and kindness. Thank you to the Haynes family for their contribution in helping us give Jackie a lovely farewell. Thank you to Sumaya for flying in at the drop of a hat to be close to the family. To Joy, Kim, Lester, and Isaac for opening up your home to us after hearing about Jackie's passing, your continued support and catering for everyone. To Claudette and Cochrane family for always being there for Jackie, making this process much seamlessly. To Earl for your companionship over the past few years, always being there for Jackie, and she could always depend on you upon her last breath. To the Nelson Mandela Foundation and Quality Bake and all the friends Jackie made along the way, thank you for showing your respect and making the effort to send Jackie off. To Auntie Ronnie, for Caitlin, when asked to do so, for everyone at the last minute. Thank you to everyone who may have, we may have forgotten. Please know that you are highly appreciated, especially during this time. I thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you all. Let us just pray before we end. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this time that we could spend here this morning. We thank you for blessing us this morning. And we thank you for everything that has been said and done here. We pray that you will be with us through the rest of this day, through the rest of this week, and with the family and relatives. We pray that you will strengthen them during this time. We pray that you will continuously remind them that you will not leave them, neither will you forsake them. In the mighty name of Jesus. Now, I pray that the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Ghost rest and abide with each and every person in this place. And all the people of God says, amen. God bless you. God make his face to shine upon you. And blessed be the name of the Lord. Amen.
another one.
Which one?
You know? Anyone. Get the mood going.
Okay. Oh.
Amazing
Grace.
Amazing Grace.
Thank you.
What's the
Hello, sorry. Can you help yourself to some refreshments on the table over there? So please make your way to the table on my right at the back there. Thank you.
Thank you. your time waiting for that second chance, for a break that would make it okay. There's always some reason to feel not good enough, and it's hard at the end of the day. I need some distraction. Oh, beautiful release. Memories seep from my veins. Let me be empty. Oh, and weightless. And maybe I'll find some peace tonight in the arms of the angel. Fly
God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the worlds thy hands hath made, I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunders, thy power throughout the universe displayed. Then sings my soul Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. And when I think that God, his Son not sparing, sent him to die, I scarce can take it in. That on that cross, my burden gladly bearing, he bled and died to take away my sin. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. When Christ shall come with shouts of acclamation and take me home, what joy shall fill my heart. Shall bow in humble adoration and there proclaim, my God, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. My soul.